the best, and I give it to Mum. She's really consistent.
Welcome back. As part of his 24-hour live Tech Santa TV marathon, Phillip Schofield has been with us all morning. How long have we got to go now?
1 hour 50, I think.
1 hour 50. Yep. Wow. You'll be fine. You'll be fine.
Nearly there.
Absolutely. Now, after 17 days, much to the surprise of lots of us, I think, Jimmy Bullard has left the jungle.
Sweet home Alabama.
What are you? Like, what sort of skill have you got?
You look like a girl.
Done it?
Yes.
Oi, oi. Oh! Get me out of this slavery jungle, get me out!
Okay, well, let's join Jimmy Bullard, who's in Australia. Oh, you're looking a bit more healthy and a bit clean. How are
Hello,
you,
Hello, Lorraine. Oh, how are you?
I'm good,
my love. Thanks for having me on.
Good. Well, what was the first thing you did when you got back out?
I had a big fry-up.
Good man.
Unbelievable.
Good man. I bet that tasted
Loved it.
Gorgeous. Yeah, good for you.
Oh, Lorraine, we're
all surprised, though. We're all surprised that you've gone.
Thank you. Yeah, I thoroughly enjoyed my time though, Lorraine. And when my name was called out, you know, I was good for it and I was on the right side, you know. So I'm happy, man, sitting right here, right now.
No regrets about going in the first place?
No regrets about going in. There was part of me, no way. There was part of me wanting to stay a little bit longer, obviously. But I loved every minute of it and what an opportunity they give me to put me in, you know.
No, absolutely.
Massively grateful.
Tell you what, Foggy's very upset. He was crying.
I know. I've seen pictures, so sad. And I don't show emotion greatly, and it even choked me up. Do you get what I mean? But got really close to him in there, and good friend for life I got there. Him and Jake also, do you get what I mean? Great boys.
Now, Phillip Schofield is with us this morning because he's been doing his massive 24-hour challenge. And he actually... Phillip, you ate eyeballs last night, in the middle of the night.
Yeah, I did the eyeball challenge, which I don't think is much to boast about.
Phil,
because
hello, mate.
Hiya, mate. I only managed about 6 or 7, so it really wasn't very special at all. To be honest, I thought I'd be much better than that, but there you go. Do you think that the banter, Bantgate, do you think that that harmed your chances in there? Because what started off as being a bit of fun with Jake ended up looking like it was a bit serious.
Yeah, I've seen that clip. It does come across to the outside looking in. You know, it can come across harsh. I understand that. I knew what I was letting myself in for. But believe me, on the inside, it was nothing like that. It's totally out of text, really. And Jake will answer that when he comes back and put that totally to bed for me, you know.
Yeah.
But we had such a laugh in there. It was totally not like that for me or Jake or anyone in there, really. You know, I am a little bit like that. Do you get what I mean? But it's totally... it was all in good jest, you know, tongue-in-cheek sort of thing.
Sure. Who do you want to win, love? Who would you like to see winning?
I would love to see Foggs win it, Foggy, or Jake, really. I've got three faves. I've got Foggy, Jake or Mel, who I went in with. Mel's lovely, honestly. Sure. She's like a bloke, really. I know I shouldn't say that, but she's lovely, and she is.
I know what you mean.
She actually is a machine. Yes.
<Thank you. laughs>
She's ripped as well. Like,
she
it's
is.
Unbelievable.
She is indeed. Thank you for talking to us. Enjoy that.
Thanks for having us on,
luxury
guys.
Luxury hotel.
Bye, mate.
Great to see
I
you.
Will.
Mel
I will.
Is like a bloke. Okay. Maybe. Now, tell you what, you could be in with a chance of winning £80,000 in this week's competition. Here's Kim Marsh.
You may have started writing your Christmas cards, but have you thought about how you'll pay for the festive season? If you won our huge prize of £80,000, that certainly won't be a problem.
What would you do if you were given a cheque for an enormous £80,000 in time for Christmas? Get yourself that dazzling outfit or two for the party season and remove some worry by clearing some of your mortgage or rent. Your New Year's resolution could be to spend the cash on a new start. Lots of money for the end of December and beyond.
So, to be in with a chance of making some of your Christmas dreams come true by winning that massive £80,000.
Text the word cash to 82248. Call 090 4161 9000. Texts cost £1.50 plus one standard network rate message. Calls cost no more than £1.54 from BT landlines. Other networks may be higher and mobiles considerably more. You can also enter for free at itv.com. Entrants must be 18 or over. Lines close at midday on Friday the 5th of December. Entrants must be contactable on the 11th of December and for 2 days after. Good luck.
Now, our Mark is here and, oh gosh, it's beginning to look a lot like Christmas.
It is, isn't it? That's what I was thinking. The must-have accessories of the season and of course, the Christmas jumper.
Yes.
It's taken on a new force, the Christmas jumper.
It's actually a good thing to do.
Absolutely. There's some amazing Christmas jumpers out there. I searched the high streets. It was a very tough job. And I found some of the best here. Some of the best you can pick up right now.
Should I take the shoes off, do you think? Should it be shoes and bare feet? It's funny like that.
Santa baby, slip a sable under the tree for me. Been an awful good girl, Santa baby, and hurry down the chimney tonight. Santa baby, an outer space convertible to light blue. I'll wait up for you, dear Santa baby, and hurry down the chimney tonight. Hurry down the chimney tonight. Hurry tonight.
Mac, I love the model.
I know.
He really was going for it.
That's the thing. We're trying to bring in all these different age ranges. It's for everybody. Exactly. Yeah, some fantastic Christmas jumpers here.
Sure.
Obviously, it is about some great tech Santa outfits as well. I've got my antlers on.
You
I've
have.
Got my little pin, that kind
yes,
of thing.
Yes, I've got one too.
We'll be looking at some of the best pieces you can pick up right now. But it is, you know, we're looking at for adults
yes.
in a mere moment. But it is for kids as well. We've got some
yeah,
gorgeous.
Is for kids.
It is. No. Well, no, the outfits. So just check out this. I just wanted to show you this. Absolutely gorgeous little pyjamas that you can pick up.
Oh,
so this is from thehut.com. You can pick up everything from there. And they are £14. And they are the Tex Santa.
Adorable.
Little PJs for the kids.
So that's
going to
help Tex Santa, which
yes,
is lovely.
Yes, and money goes towards all those charities as well. Shall we take a look, though, at our first model?
Yes, please.
Okay, all right, then. We've seen him before, and here he is again. I am very impressed with the fact that he's accessorised the onesie because it's his stylist's own with some beautiful shoes. You see, I tweeted Phillip before, I told him to work it and to own it, and I think you have.
Oh, that is genius.
I think you absolutely have. I'm going to point out how flattering the onesie is, the lines working down the body is elongated, Phillip. And the way you're working that hood is...
It's
just amazing. The onesie comes in at a mere £18.
Oh, it's a bargain.
But you make it look $1 million.
It does.
You really
should have worn that to meet the Prime Minister, don't you think?
There we go. That's right. Make it a little bit more.
Is it comfortable?
Come and sit down.
Yeah, actually, of course it's comfy. It's lovely.
It is comfy.
Yeah, it is. I've never been very good with a hood, if I'm honest.
Well, I think you're carrying it off today.
Don't look so hot in that.
You've got a great design on the inside here as well.
Look at that.
So that is the Ben Mosley design there. Very nice indeed.
And it's all for Tech Santa. So it's
all for Tech Santa, and I think it's absolutely marvellous. Should we take a look at our next one?
Please.
Model? We have the lovely Wendy Peters. Here she
Wendy?
Is.
Wendy?
I know.
Good.
I'm loving this T-shirt.
That's
and so
really
Wendy,
t-shirt.
You were quite impressed with this,
I quite
you?
Like this T-shirt, okay. Yeah.
It's looking good. Great kind of abstract print there as well. Again, from Ben Mosley, the artist. And I think that looks really quite beautiful. Very nicely cut, a good low neckline as well. Gorgeous little Tech Santa hat. I'm thinking channeling a bit of Jackie O there as well. With
definitely,
that little,
with the pillbox hat. absolutely, of course.
Very
gorgeous.
Chic, very elegant, very sophisticated. Thank you very much, my darling. Next up. Tom Chambers.
Oh, wow, he's going for it.
You should have been. That's what I should have done.
No, I mean, you did it serious, but you know.
I know.
We want sexiness, we want a bit.
Listen,
of
every model has their style.
That is true. That is true.
You've got tickets to the gun show.
a nice Christmas tan. She'll get you to wear the jumper underneath.
Lovely. How much is this?
Oh, do you want to know that? Okay. The T-shirt is £12. £12 for that T-shirt there. Do you know what I'm quite liking about it? Is the fact that actually, if you look closely, it does have little Santas on and elves' legs. Oh. But from a distance, it looks almost like a paisley pattern. So you could actually continue wearing that throughout the year.
Okay.
So for £12,
I'm not going to do that.
Next up, let's have Mr. Alan Jones.
Yay.
Oh, look at the we sorry face.
Oh. I'm just glad it's not a snowman.
I wanted a snowman. But that looks lovely. I like
that's a nice
that.
One, isn't it? Yeah. I'm liking that.
That looks lovely, actually, did you say?
Does it lovely?
You're wearing that really well.
Oh, thanks.
This is your time of year.
Shut up. Can I go now? You start.
Very well cut jumper, beautiful forest green, and I'm liking the design.
Are you?
I really am.
Well, you can have it if you like.
Can I?
Yeah, it'll
I'll
fit you.
You. All right, then, okay. £15 for that, which I think is actually a
bargain.
Really good price point.
That's
all
awesome.
The other, yeah, they are, aren't they? Yeah, but all the Christmas jumpers on the high street are all coming in around 30. I think £15 for that, with the money going to Tech Santa as well, is all good news. I think it's very smart indeed.
Thank you. I've really enjoyed wearing it for you.
Have you?
Thank you so much.
Never look better.
Thank you, dear. You too.
Thank you.
But the guys are going to be singing later, aren't they, on the ITV3 show?
Yeah.
They're going to sing White Christmas.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to pop along as well.
Are you coming?
Yeah, you're not getting rid of me. I'm going to come with you.
That would be lovely. That would be fabulous. Well, we're on the countdown now, you know, not long to go.
Not long, lovely.
I don't think we're quite in single figures yet, but...
But the chequered flag is there. 138.
138. Hour and a half.
You can do this. You can do this. I have to say, I think what you've achieved is remarkable. Absolutely amazing. I think we should have a round of applause for our Phil.
Oh, thank you, Brian.
And for all the guys who've been... But we're nearly there, And everybody that's been with you, they've been amazing, haven't they?
It's been incredible. The whole night, the whole 24 hours have been such fun. The whole building pulled together. It was brilliant.
It's such a buzz about the place this morning, isn't there? It's a brilliant atmosphere. It's wonderful. Well done.
Thank you.
And that's it for today. Tomorrow we're going to be talking to Hollywood's Bill Murray and, of course, the latest celebrity to leave the jungle. Who's that going to be? Well, it'll be up to you. They'll be joining us live from Australia on this very show. You have a lovely, lovely day. Bye.
Everybody do what they want for one day only. Except if you're a robber.
Weetabix sponsors Lorraine, fueling chatter.
Hello, coming up later on Loose Women, Annie Lennox, the singer with a unique and soulful voice who sold over 80 million records. With a singing career spanning an incredible...
There we are.
Thank you,
Flora.
So you're going back to...
You're going as well, Lorraine?
Yes. Should I take this out?
Yeah,
you
can grab it as you leave.
I'll give that to you. I'll just get my phone.
Right then. Mm-hmm. Okay. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you, guys.
Cheers.
See you later. Thank you.
So we're going to our green room.
Thank you. Where are we going now?
To our green room.
Your green room. Okay. outside the gents. Celebrity faces, including Essex beauty Amy Childs and a performance from the cast of White Christmas. Plus, we've got even more great fundraising ideas. So what about... So we've got Amy Childs. Amy Childs is here. What could she make you part with your money for Tech Santa? Perhaps give you some beauty tips, perhaps, or give some of her classic catchphrases. Send in your suggestions via Twitter at ITV Tech Santa or facebook.com/TechSantaITV. If Amy accepts your challenge, be prepared to Tech Santa your money. And just remind you that the six charities benefiting from the 2014 Tech Santa appeal are Teenage Cancer Trust, Guide Dogs, Well Child, Marie Curie, Alzheimer Society, and Together for Short Lives. 100% of every donation will be split equally between this year's Tech Santa charities. Donations to our Tech Santa appeal couldn't be easier. So to give £5, text Santa5 to 70760. Or if you can stretch to £10, then you text Santa10 to 70760. You must be over 16, or you've got to certainly ask the bill payer's permission, or donate by telephone, call 0300 123 6060. Standard charges may apply. Please check with your operator, or you can donate online at the Text Santa website. 100% of your donation will go to the Text Santa charities. Right, it's time to open doors 21 and 22.
How are you at numbers, Philip?
Of my,
can we already you open 21? The next door?
Oh, someone had that whilst I was out. You were skipping it. How can you skip one? You can't skip one. Because apparently I've got a bit of catching up to do. Hello, darling. You're standing there in the background. I was leaving you. Chat. Well, can I just open my advent calendar? Do you mind? Right. Okay. So number 22. Is there 22? Here is a hat, and it is watch the monitor.
Philip, wake up! I know you're not asleep. I know you're working hard to stay up 24 hours for your Tech Santa campaign. All you people out there watching, help him, call him, send donations. Donations definitely keep him awake. If you're having any other trouble staying awake, get the caffeine IV. Always works for me. Coffee, pole, needle. Walk around with it. Very pretty picture. All right? Hey, and your hair's looking a little bad too. Need me to send you a hat? Got plenty of these around for you. All right? Good luck. Keep up what you're doing. Wake up!
Now, he is a cool dude. Thank you very much indeed, Sam. That's magic, and I do have my hat. Thank you. Right then, it's nearly 23 hours down, only one to go. Still got time for another push to inspire your fundraising. Everyone's got a Christmas tree, but not everyone has got a Christmas angel to decorate it. Today, you have, in the form of Linda Barker, and she's here with some crafty ways to make personalised decorations for your tree. While you are at it, why not make a few extra to sell to your friends and family to raise money for Tech Santa? So, there we go. This is what we're going to do. I've got a... You're not mic'd, so I'm going to give you that one. You've got to use your hands, so I'll hold it for you.
It's there you all go. Brilliant.
Don't you worry, I am
You're
now.
You're looking fabulous,
human
by the
boom.
Way. Oh, human boom, thank
right,
you.
Go for it.
Right, we want to decorate inexpensively, and more importantly, I want to get kids involved making Christmas decorations, just crafting at home with their parents, whatever, so that they can go to school with these decorations and sell them to raise some money. So I've got some beautiful, inexpensive ideas for people to do at home.
Right.
What we want to start with is a bit of origami, if I may. And I've folded these beautiful little stars. If I hold it up against the tree, that looks really sweet. And this is just a piece.
Are they complicated to make? Because maybe could you get your kids to do it?
You can get the kids to do it. I'm going to show you quickly how to do the folds. They can always go and have a look on YouTube as well, because origami folds are all on YouTube. But I'll show you quickly, because it's just a piece of paper, so it costs nothing. You know, if you're sat at the computer, just take a sheet out of the printer and use that.
You could also, because there's little spaces there to write, so you could leave little messages, or this in this star is this present. present or you have won, whatever.
Indeed, you are so creative. I love your creativity. Yeah, so these look
buying them a present, isn't it?
Super pretty, yeah. And I reckon if kids made these, they could sell them for £1 at school. Make 20, there we go, you do the maths. All you need to start with, importantly, most origami starts with a square, but this starts with a pentagon. So you can download a pentagon shape from the web and use that to cut out your piece of paper. And then you start folding. So here you fold it in five. So you get basically that lovely shape there. Can you see those folds there? I think you can, can't you? Yeah. So that's your first set of folds. It's a pentagon, so we're working in fives all the time. So corner to corner, if that makes sense, with a five point. So you end up with those, that kind of diamond pattern in the middle. Your second fold is you take the left-hand flap with a point at the top and fold that in so that this point here touches the crease line at the top and the bottom edge of the paper touches the crease line at the bottom.
All right.
And you do that five times. And then you open it all up. You can start to see that star shape with the folds, actually. Then you, with the point at the top, you fold in the left-hand side. You fold in the right-hand side. You can already start, the star wants to take shape. You fold the flap up at the back and you pull this little point flat.
I've already thrown that up the kitchen.
You've got to stick with it. You've got to stick with it. Okay, so that starts, this starts to happen. And once all those folds are made, all the points kind of fold in on themselves and you start to see this characteristic star shape. Then all you do, it's a bit kind of clumpy, that one. You take it to the back and you fold the points in half. And that is your five-pointed star origami. Costs you nothing, sell for a quid and make some money for Tech Santa. Lovely. You'll be there. You'll be there.
Give it a go.
Give it a go. My second decoration is for really pretty tree garlands. This is super simple. We could hang this on our tree. Woo! Okay. There we go. All kind of...
This is why they invented neck mics.
Oh, so sorry, Philip. Now, this is inspired by these lovely stationery dots. You get these, £1.25 for a pack of, I know, six sheets or something in the stationers. And all you need do is stick them onto a piece of cotton or a piece of thread. I've got some lime green dots here, which look really sweet. I think they might be rather nice under there. They're Christmas decorated. Philip.
You don't like tinsel, do you?
I love tinsel.
Do you?
I love tinsel. I think anything goes at Christmas. Look, people have just not got to get too hooked up on creating a minimalist tree. I think everything goes. Mm. My top tip this year is actually for, you know, we usually, all of us, have big boxes of baubles and all the rest of it, and it's a bit of a mess. Take them all out, separate them into colours, whatever you have the most of, like if it's dark, so you go from your dark colours to your medium colours to your pale, sparkly colours and clear at the top. Mm-hmm. You still with me?
Yeah.
Whatever you got most of, start at the bottom of the tree and work upwards, so you have this lovely kind of ombre look to your tree, from dark to pretty lights
like
at the top.
I like it. Is it true that would I be on trend if I bought metallic this year?
You'd be very on trend, especially if it was copper.
Oh, what is that?
Yeah, copper is bang on trend.
What are the other things that you've got here? We've only got a couple of minutes, so let's rattle us through.
If we can do so, inexpensive wreaths from craft shops, all that kind of thing. And I want to show you how to just jazz it up.
Can you do it in 30 seconds?
30 seconds, I'll try. Basically, start with your wreath. Wire everything that you're going to put into that wreath. So wire your ribbons, big ribbons, small ribbons. Wire frosted fruit. Here's some I did earlier. This is a lime. So all you need to do...
What have you frosted that with?
Caster sugar. So you stab your
lime... Will that stay on if you put it outside?
It should be fine.
Really?
It should be fine. Okay. It's sort of air-dried. I mean, it's not going to withstand a hurricane.
No, fair enough. But the rain, be all right in the rain?
It'd be okay in a bit of damp.
Okay. Put it in the porch in a bit of shelter.
Indeed, inside is proper.
Okay.
So with your lime, stab it with florist wire, give yourself a little handle, wash it with egg white, dust it with caster sugar and leave it a couple of hours to dry. And, mm-hmm. and it does go, you see, it does go quite hard.
Yeah.
So everything is wired, including your little clumps of baubles on wires, then stick everything into your wreath. And look what I've made you. You could even do a little letter.
Oh. A little pea.
Wrapped in a little pea, just for you. Wrapped in this. I've just used this, which is
because it's raffia.
It's like a paper ribbon. It's 99p a roll, and it goes a long way.
It's that time again, Philip. Time to open another door on the advent calendar.
Another door on the advent calendar.
Okay, let me hold that.
Yeah, hold that for me. I've got to open 21. Right. Okay. 21. Watch the monitor.
Hey, Philip. It's RJ Mitty. I see that you're running 24 hours. On this day, I hope you're holding up fairly well. Sending you some herbal remedy, unlike Walter White's unorthodox remedies. But hopefully, you're having a very Merry Christmas.
Wow! Now that is cool, Mr. Breaking Bad himself.
Amazing.
I mean, I just love it. Thank you very much indeed, RJ. Thank you. And you've done that.
I'm starting, Philip. So
I'll leave you. Is it all right if I leave you in there?
You just leave me to do it.
Right. Okay then. right then, let's have a look to see how you are how you're fundraising, because we've got some. It says here messages on the iPad, but I don't know that I've necessarily got an iPad, so I'm going to come and chat with you.
Yeah, no worries.
Is that
I've
all
got
right?
tons of treats coming in for you.
What have you got?
Well, just saying how fantastic you are, basically, and how when you were on my show earlier on and you had a onesie on, that went down very well, that onesie. Because, of course, all of those things that were modelled all go towards Tech Santa, so
yeah.
It's brilliant.
I don't think we need that anymore,
yes,
do we?
Do.
Oh, I still do. Okay, of course I do.
Do you want me to hold it? You've been up all night. You look so well. You look so fresh. Look at that wee fresh boyish face.
It's a surreal sort of feeling, actually. Yeah. Getting to this stage of it is lovely.
There.
And I've met, what's also great is that I've met representatives, recipients, people who benefited from all of the charities, and so there have been you know, so many of the shows on ITV have been looking at one particular charity for Tech Santa.
Sure, you do Alzheimer's, amazing response already.
What made you go? What you made? Made you
I
go
think
with
it affects so many people, Philip. I mean, I don't think there's anybody that hasn't been affected by it in some way or another.
Yeah,
and I certainly from close friends who've lost people, but they're still alive.
Yeah.
It's that horrible thing. But there's so much more that you can do now. And obviously, people being very generous, that all goes to research. All of the money raised by Tech Santa will help research, but also help in a very practical way. So I think it's really, really important. But all the charities are fantastic. Mm. And they all really deserve our help. They really do. They're amazing. So what you've been doing is just fantastic. It's amazing.
Well, it's,
it really is. It's brilliant.
It's been very good fun. I think I probably... It's the those moments where you end up almost ITV3 is behind the scenes
of the other
stuff that we've been doing.
That's what I've loved, though. I've loved watching you. And so many people have been up all night with you.
Yeah, which is great.
Which is
just
fantastic. When was the last time that you pulled a 24-hour round? You must have been, what, in your teens? Maybe
no,
not.
No,
I'm trying to think
more,
back when I was up for 24 hours, not through work, but through fun.
More recently. Well, you do it on planes occasionally, don't you? If you're
that's
going on
true,
holiday, there's a
and
long
you watch lots
flight,
of movies.
And then you watch lots of movies.
Yeah.
You know, maybe a little bit of that. But no, straight the way through, no stopping, no nothing.
Amazing.
No, it's been a while. It's been a while. How are you spending Christmas?
Vet family. Just family. Yeah, and the full traditional thing. Absolutely everything. You know, the prawn cocktail, the turkey, the whole lot of it. And I try not to get stressed. I try to say to myself, it's a Sunday dinner with ideas above its station. That's all it is. That's all it is.
Precisely.
You know, it's just, you know, it's been a bit diva-esque, so we just treat it in that way.
Can I also just point out that in the dead of night, we had a phone in, and Denise was taking calls from celebrities who were wanting to confess things.
Yes.
And we had a confession from a celebrity called Lorraine, who said that she'd been living a lie, and in actual fact, she wasn't Scottish, but she was living in Windsor.
I know. It's me. I know. It's so embarrassing.
Good
but
voice.
I am actually English.
You are,
I am.
You are English.
Yes.
And we've left it until all of all the exposés, all the stories, all the things that we've discussed today.
I know.
This is going to come as such a shock.
I know. It's been very, very difficult, actually, to try and pretend. But, you know, it's been quite successful.
I suspect probably it's like a weight off your mind now.
It is. Now that I've managed to do that. But, yeah, I'm coming back into Scottish now because I've been doing it for so long.
Well, I understand completely. What
that was brilliant.
What reactions did you get from people?
People on Twitter were saying, we knew. We knew you were only pretending to be Scottish. We knew, really, you were from Berkshire.
I knew it all along.
That was such good fun. It's such good fun.
That's, we might have the clip, actually. I don't know whether we can run it. Here you go.
Hello. Oh, I'm living a lie. I'm a successful morning TV presenter, got my foot in the door as Scotland correspondent. The truth is, as you can hear, I'm not actually Scottish. Now, 30 years on, it's gone too far and I need to come clean. I've even had to buy a house in Dundee and commute to London for work when secretly my family all live in Windsor. Help me.
Denise was thrilled to help.
Denise,
did you hear her advice? Because you're probably in bed by that stage because you've got to get up and do the show.
I should have been with you. I feel bad.
Denise said to Lorraine.
Yes, yes, yes.
She said that it would be such a shock to the nation that you must continue to live the lie.
So I will continue to live the lie.
Yes,
I will put it behind me and I will protect. You've got whatever she says you have to do.
Oh, you do know.
Because she knows everything.
It's the law.
It is the law.
It's the law. Thank you, my darling.
Oh, it's
thank
great
you.
To thank see you.
Thank
you
so
luck.
Much.
Good
thank
luck.
You.
Brilliant.
Thank you. It's time for a quick break, but remember that I am always with you. All you have to do is to look on ITV.com or on the other side of the break. Obviously, we'll still be here, but we are streaming the whole way. Every break is streamed. There are no hiding places until 11 o'clock and then I'm gone and you won't see me anywhere. but streaming on the ITV website if you want to have a look at that. See you in a minute. There we go. Back on ITV3. Welcome back. In a matter of minutes, I'll be heading down to the place where this challenge began nearly 24 hours ago, and that is on the set of this morning. Also, be finding out how many of the fundraising cyclists have made it to Lapland. I suspect quite a lot, actually. They've been really successful overnight. Ryland will be taking part in the Globe of Terror Challenge for Tech Santa. That you can't miss. But first, I'm now down in our little studio cafe with a lady known for her ability to jazzle up everything. And she's fundraising here with her very own nail bar. It's Amy Charles. And welcome,
Yay!
Ladies. Welcome, Amy.
Hello.
Hello, darling.
How are you?
I'm very well, thank you. Oh, it's nice. That's very lovely to sit down. You actually have done some work for the Teenage Cancer Trust, haven't you?
Yep, I help. Made quite a lot of wigs for the young girls. I absolutely loved it. Yeah, because I obviously love my big hair, and I actually made some wigs for
That's
Teenage
great.
Cancer
And what,
Trust.
What are you What are you doing here for the ladies?
So,
what can you do for their nails?
So I am making them with beautiful polishes, and nice and sparkly. Because obviously I love my sparkle. So I've had the girls in this morning, and for jazzing them up, can I just say?
Have you?
Well, I have got my pajamas on me, but no, we'll just be pajamasing there now
in
today.
The cafe?
We can do it in the cafe, can't we, girls?
And so let's have a look through the various bits and pieces that you've got. So you've got letters and stuff you can put.
So I've got vajazzles, and obviously for Christmas I do love vajazzling, don't we all girls? But also today I'm talking about nails. So I think for Christmas with your girls' nails, you have to really go all out there. And what I do is I really go out there with the sparkles. So I've got my girls with me, they've had a bit of, a bit of purple, a bit of silver.
Pop that down there.
Would you have that, Phil?
Do you know? No.
At the minute you would.
No, even now, I'm not that hysterical even now. But don't look at my nails because I have cooked breakfast, I have been digging in stuff and goodness knows what.
You need a nice manicure.
My nails are absolutely filthy at the moment. I do give them a bit of a buff though.
Okay, cuticle remover, did you do all that?
No, I can't be bothered with all that, but I give them a bit of a rub.
Men should be doing this.
Really?
Yeah, like cuticles, filing their nails because women do look at men's nails.
Oh.
I do anyway.
Do you?
Yeah.
Okay. What about Christmas itself? How many people do you have around for Christmas?
So this year I'm in my new house and I'm cooking for 14 people. And can I just say, I can't actually cook, so I don't actually know how the food is going to be after.
What are you cooking?
I'm cooking turkey, vegetables. Mum is going to help me, but I don't think I'm going to be able to do it.
So there is it family that's coming around?
Family's coming around.
So the responsibility of 14 people, and you don't know whether they're going to be able to eat it?
How bad is that?
Right. No, maybe just do their nails.
Do their nails, a bit of sparkle, can't go wrong.
You got a new puppy?
I've got a new puppy, Leonardo. I love Leonardo DiCaprio, so when I got my puppy, I said I'm going to call him Leonardo.
I love it. This is the most random 24 hours in my whole life. It's just... But have you done all of these, ladies?
No, I've just done... I've done a few of the girls, but when you go, I'm going to finish them all off.
All right. Do you want to start on someone else, if that's all right? I'm just going to read you, whilst you carry that out, a couple of things that have come in on Facebook. Zoe on Facebook says, apart from sleeping, what's the first thing you're going to do when you finish your 24 hours? Do you know, I have a feeling it could be a bath, actually. I've got a feeling that could be it. Sharon on Facebook, will this become an annual event? No. From Sally Ann on Facebook, how are you feeling about climbing the Shard? I can't wait for it. I'm just desperate now that the weather, we get a crystal clear blue sky, because we've got all the helicopters ready to fly around and cover that. So that would be amazing. Did the abseil help you prepare for it? Yep. When do you think you'll sleep? This evening, but I don't want to sleep too early. Otherwise, you then it'll be like I've got jet lag and I won't sleep properly tonight. What's been your favourite part of the broadcast? That is really tough. I think the Downing Street today was fascinating and fabulous, that we were the first live broadcast ever to come out of the Cabinet Room. That was great. The abseil was amazing. The weather was terrific. Presenting the weather was really superb. I absolutely loved doing that, the continuity in between shows. But it would be, if you look at what we've accomplished and what we've done, I think, how many guests have we had over the 24 hours? We reckon just under 200 guests we've had in the last 24 hours. So to pick one bit out, we've had a tweet from the Prime Minister. News just in. Fantastic to help Schofe and ITV Tech Santa 24 with the first ever live interview from Number 10's Cabinet Room. And that just in from the Prime Minister. Yay! Thank you, Prime Minister. Gillian on Facebook says, after your fisheye challenge, would you ever consider going into the jungle for Imus Lake? Do you know what? I was really disappointed. I gagged. I thought I'd be really good at that. I only got about 7 in my mouth and then I gagged and I was gutted. I'm putting that down to the fact that I might have been a bit tired. Finally, Angie from Up With The Cyclists on the second floor. We're going to check in with them in just a moment. You said you enjoyed reading the weather so much. Would you consider a career change to a weatherman? No, I'm going to leave that part of the job to them because they're far better. I just did it the once, but they do it brilliantly every single day. So thank you very much indeed for all your tweets and your Facebook messages. Thank you for coming in.
Thank you so much.
That's really, really appreciated. Amy has all the details of how to donate on our website, and so she obviously pointed you in the right direction there. Time to open door 23 of my advent calendar.
Philip, so if you'll excuse me, I'm just going to go and... A number of advent calendar have already been opened.
I know.
Your challenge is to open one more.
One more. Which one? It's 23, actually, I think. So let's open... Hey, my missus is here! I keep finding her behind doors!
Not me!
This one. I keep finding her behind doors. It's like my own advent calendar. You're behind makeup one. Let's see you later. Right, OK. Here we go.
Nearly there, Philip.
So close. So close. Right, number 23. Is it 23? Okay, so we've skipped one, haven't we? 23. And, dear Philip, watch the monitor.
Hi, Schofe. Ball here. Hope you're well. I can't imagine how stressful presenting 24 hours of live television must be, especially when it gets to this crazy hour in the morning. So being the helpful person that I am, here are a couple of stress balls to get those morning stresses and worries under control, right? Some balls from Ball. Here we go. Give them a squeeze. Good luck.
Magic. Thank you very much indeed, Zoe. And there we go. I've just... giving those stress balls a bit of a squeeze. Although, if you were watching earlier on, you will know that we pioneered and I think previewed exclusively, I haven't seen them before, stress mushrooms.
And that was a sight to behold. Right, it's time for a quick break, but remember, I am here live and uninterrupted. If you go to ITV.com, you can see the streaming. We're all over the website, and you can see what happens, what we do behind the scenes when we go to a commercial break. Just check that I'm not actually sleeping. First, a quick reminder of how you can donate to Tech Santa.
Santa needs all the help he can get. Some of them elves are getting pretty old, so help him.
To donate £5, text SANTA5 to 70760.
Or, if you can stretch it to £10, text SANTA10.
Remember, you must be 16 or over, and please ask the bill payer's permission.
Don't fancy texting? Then just call 0300 123 6060.
Standard charges may apply, so please do check with your operator and be ready with your payment details.
Or you can even donate online.
And the best news of all is 100% of your money goes direct to the charities.
All I want for Christmas is you.
Don't be a Scrooge and donate right now.
We are. Final costume change. Welcome back as I near the end of my 24-hour live TV marathon for Tech Central. Lovely nails. On the set of Lorraine, I chatted to Alan Jones and to Tom Chambers and also to Wendy Peters, of course, from the West End Christmas show White Christmas. Now, as promised, it is time to see them perform exclusively for us. White Christmas runs until the 3rd of January at the Dominion Theatre. So as we walk through into our studio, this was Alan Jones' first ever West End role. Matter of fact, in case you didn't know that, he plays Bob Willis. Tom Chambers is Bill Davies. It is based on the 1954 film of the same name, starring Bing Crosby. And they're all standing here in front of us as I say, take it away, the cast of White Christmas.
Christmas, just like the ones I used to know, where the treetops glisten and children listen to hear sleigh bells in the snow.
In the front row.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness, that is such a phrase. What a treat to be so close to all your voices, by the way. I mean, I could hear each one individually. Incredible. But nevertheless, a little freaky for you to have me quite so close here. Right, thank you very much, guys. Have a very, very Merry Christmas. White Christmas, tell me the theatre.
Dominion.
Lovely, brilliant. Thank you, guys. Thank you very much. Right, I think this way now, around the other side of the Christmas tree. And I'm going to open my final advent calendar window. So all day I've been asking people to send me Schofe, so I'll make this one last opportunity to get your camera out, get close to the telly and sort of celebrate the last moment with me. So you want to post it, then we'd love to see it. Look at those glittery pom-poms! Right, there we go. Right, well, I should pose for a Schofe, really. Well, we haven't got a camera. Have you? Someone got a camera?
Yeah.
I tell you what. I'll post now, so that you can... I'll do it in front of the advent calendar. So, right, OK, do it in front of the advent calendar, because we're about... This will be the last time you see it. So if I pose here, get your camera out. So get your camera now, I'll wait until if you're rushing around, and then, of course, you've got to wait to switch it on, and then you can't remember the code, and... if you're ready, so what we want are pictures with you in front of the telly, with me, in this shot. Ready? OK, so if you come a bit closer... There we go. There you go. There's your shot. How many of those can you do?
To complete this game, you must open the final door on your advent calendar. Can you handle the pressure?
24. Who thought we'd ever get there? 24. Okay, let's read the Europe, the final countdown. Well, this is it, Phillip. Huge congratulations on almost completing your challenge. This is the final push, so here is a song we hope will inspire you to jump over that final hurdle. You are definitely our consonant vowel hero from the countdown team. And that's genius. Thank you very much. How long have we got to go? Was that 54 minutes? Right, since this is the final countdown, it is time for me to make my way to the This Morning studio, where Rylan is going to be undertaking his challenge, the Globe of Terror. So we'll walk our way through. Thank you very much. It feels really strange to be coming through. Lovely. What, so which way are we going? I was going to say, that's not the way.
No. Come on, cheerleaders.
Oh, you're coming too.
It's the final countdown. The final countdown.
There you go.
I do keep saying, stop following me around. Right then. Here we go. Up the steps to This Morning. So peculiar to be finishing it off where I started. Here's the team.